Hi, I'm Bob Thomason. This is Monday, May the 7th, 2018. I've done a number of videos on C60, Carbon 60. Piqued a lot of interest in that area, and I thought since there's a lot of common interest in cryptocurrencies, then I decided I would do a series of videos on my experiences with a cryptocurrency or a crypto tokens. Now, to start with, just one disclaimer here. I'm not an investment advisor. This is not investment advice. This is merely my experience. I'm just relaying my experience on what I've done in the cryptocurrency market. So you're welcome to listen to what I have to say, but do your own research before you do any purchases. All right, I got started in early part of last year with cryptocurrencies. I didn't really know anything about it. A fellow that I had done business with a number of times contacted me early last year and approached me on putting a program together for cryptocurrency mining, and he explained what he was doing. So we decided to do that, and then later on I kind of let that rock for a while, because that takes a while just to get everything going, get the equipment built, get software done. So about August of last year, I decided, well, you know, I'm already doing the mining, but I think it's time for me to also test the water or learn something about token purchase. And I had seen a few videos online and seen where most people seem to be, here in the US at least, seem to be using Coinbase as their place to get tokens from. So I set up a Coinbase account, set up a credit card on there, and also set up a bank account, attached a bank account to that, to Coinbase. All this takes several days to a week to get everything accomplished. And then I made my first token purchase in around the first week of August last year. Once I did that, I knew I needed to get a wallet of some sort to put on my computer, and I emailed a friend of mine who was pretty versed in this stuff, and he suggested that I use either Exodus or a Jax wallet. That's what he'd been using. So I decided I'd set up an Exodus wallet, and I learned how to transfer tokens from my Coinbase account to my Exodus wallet, and then I also played with exchanging tokens, which you can do within Exodus. You can exchange tokens within that wallet. Now, understand, anytime you move tokens from one place to another, there is a small fee, a very small fee that is involved in that, but it's a very nominal fee. It's nothing like, you know, bank fees or anything like that. It's just a very minute fee, which is a network fee. There's several terms for it, but didn't mind paying that fee at all. It's a small, you don't really worry about it. And I made a number of purchases, both with credit card and with bank transfers, over the period of months last fall. Then after the first of the year, I decided that I would make another purchase. Prices were good, so I decided I'd make another purchase. And this one was going to be $300, put it on a credit card like I normally done. And then what happened a few days later is I noticed on my credit card account that on that purchase, they had charged an additional $15 fee. And then sometime later, when the statement was available, I also noticed that they charged me interest rate immediately. and a higher interest rate than I would normally be subject to. And what they had done is they reclassified these purchases as cash advance. So with cash advance, you're subject to higher interest rate, and you're subject to a transaction fee. And so I decided then that, well, you know, they got me once, but I won't do that again. So any future purchases I'll do with just a bank transfer. And the only difference is you don't lose anything. The bank transfer, it just takes a while. It takes a week before you have access to those tokens. The tokens sit there, whatever you purchase, and there's no change in, you know, no value problem or anything there. It's just that you don't get your hands on them for a week. And I didn't want that. I wanted them, you know, instantly. But I'm willing to wait now. And I've also heard that there are some credit card companies that won't allow you to do cryptocurrency purchases. So, you know, the market's new, things are changing, but I just wanted to take a few minutes and spend a little bit of time here to kind of break the ice, kind of get, you know, started on this. I'll do some more videos in this as well. This all takes time and, you know, a little bit of money to put these videos together, time and effort. If you would like to donate, then, you know, I would certainly appreciate that. I'm going to put or list a couple of token addresses in the description here. So if you would like to donate a little bit, you know, a few dollars, a few cents, whatever, if you'd like to donate a little bit, feel free to do so. I would really appreciate that. So with that, I'm going to let you go, and I'll do some more follow-up videos a little bit later.